Koffie.
Nog meer zeker nodig, dat kan ik goed. Oké, check. I'm on the
button. Hey you, and welcome to my channel. My name is Tina, and my aim is to improve your drawings just like others have done for me when I just started out. So, you're new to the world of pastel and you want to know even more about them, then you've come to the right place. Sometimes soft pastel can be overwhelming. I mean, you have pencils, soft pastels, soft sticks, pan pastel, and there is even a lot of choice when it comes to your paper. So, welcome to Pastel 101. A quick reminder, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, make sure you do that right now. I truly appreciate all of the support and this really helps my channel grow, so thank you in advance. Now, let's start with what soft pastel is not, because oftentimes it gets confused with oil pastel. It is definitely not the same as an oil pastel. The way they are made is quite similar. They both are, for the most part, pure pigment, but soft pastel is made with a binder like starch, whereas oil pastel, you guessed it, is made with oil as a binder. Besides having their name in common, I don't find a lot of similarities between the two. For instance, soft pastel is a really fragile medium that can break easily, while oil pastels, on the other hand, don't need to be handled with the same amount of care. Another difference can be found in the way you blend them. With soft pastel, you can put them on in any direction you'd like, where oil pastels are the best layered in the same direction to achieve a smooth blend. I could go a bit more in depth about their difference, and if you would like me to do that, make sure to leave a comment down below. But for the purpose of this video, all you need to know is that they are definitely not the same. So, now that I've got that out of the way, let's get back to the basics of soft pastel. What they are and everything you need to know to get started with them. So, what are soft pastels? Like I mentioned in my intro, they are a powdered pigment with a binder added to them to hold them together. The pigments used in them are the same type used in watercolors and oil paints, and the only difference really is the binder used. Now, soft pastel comes in a variety of forms, so I'll walk you through the different types. In total, I would say there are four different categories. Here I've laid them all out for you to see. So let me start with the traditional soft pastels like these ones you see over here. Now, I also use the term soft pastel as a general term to make sure it's not too confusing with oil pastels. These have a high percentage of pigment and less binder. They can be made by hand like the ones from Unison or the ones from Schmincke, but they can also be made using a machine. Within this type, they vary on how hard or soft they are. The softer the pastel, the more delicate they are in general, but they will also disperse pastel much quicker compared to a harder type. With the harder types, you will have a much easier time getting in harder lines though. The next type of soft pastel is the pastel sticks, like the ones you see here. Now, I've only got a set of Conte à Paris pastel sticks because this type of pastel isn't really suited for my type of art. These have more binder and less pigment in them, and they are machine-made, which explains why they are harder. This also makes them way more suited for sketching and line art since they have no trouble producing lines. These ones, however, are not the type you want to use to color your underlayer since they don't deposit a lot of color. Also, another thing to note is that you shouldn't use these on top of thick layers of soft pastel since they will just scrape it off. The next type of soft pastel is most likely the one you are most familiar with, and those are the pastel pencils. I'm going to state the obvious here, but this is just pastel surrounded by a wooden casing. Now, on a hardness scale, these can go from soft to hard. It all depends on the brand you use. For example, the pastel pencils from Caran d'Ache are extremely soft, whereas the pencils from Faber-Castell tend to be more on the hard side. Even when you have a softer pencil in your hand, one of the biggest advantages of the pencils is the fact that you can easily draw details with them. They are also a great option if you don't like the feeling of soft pastel in your hand. Some people just don't like the dry texture of pastel on their fingers, and for those people, I would say go for a combination of pencils with pan pastel. So let's jump straight into the last type of soft pastel, and that's pan pastel. This is a type of pastel that has the most pigment in it and the least amount of binder. As you can see, the pan pastel just sits in a small tray because there is no way this would stay in any form or shape otherwise. That is the primal job of a binder, and since pan pastels are very low on binder, it's only possible to use them as a compact powder. Unlike all the other types of pastel, you can't apply pan pastel directly on your paper. You do need some extra tools to apply them. I've seen people do this with brushes or even with cotton tips. but I do have to say that the soft tools, which are from the company themselves, are the best applicators for the pan pastel. I personally find that you can blend the smoothest with pan pastel. I'm assuming this is because pan pastels are very finely grinded. And one small con of pan pastel is that they are a little bit less opaque compared to the other types. I think this is because they disperse so much pastel, so this is both a pro as a con, depending on how you look at it. This makes correcting errors a little bit trickier though. I'm going to cover a minimum of things you need in order to get started with pastel. If you want a video a little bit more in depth, I suggest you check out my beginner pastel supply video. I'll have the link appear in your screen as well as in the description below. Basically, if you want to try out pastel, you only need two things, and that is paper and pastel, of course. Now I'm going to start with paper. In my opinion, the paper you can work on with pastel come in four different categories. The first one is an ingress or plate texture, and this isn't a bad paper, but it is limited to the amount of layers it can take. The next texture is the honeycombed or dimple texture. This paper is quite similar to the first texture I mentioned, but like the name says, the pattern in your piece will be more honeycombed or dimpled. And the third type is a gritty surface. This is by far my biggest favorite when it comes to pastel paper, and in a second I will go a little bit more into detail into one of my most favorite papers. And the fourth category is velour paper. If this is your first try, I would stay away from the velour paper, as I find this to be a more difficult paper to start off with. For me, it's quite simple. I find Clairefontaine's Pastel Mat to be the best paper out there. Like I mentioned before, this is a paper that falls in the gritty surfaces. In short, I prefer this paper for three reasons. The first one is that the paper can take the most amount of layers that I have found so far. If you want to draw in a realistic art style, this is very important. You can only achieve realism by adding depth to your pieces, for which you need a lot of layers. The second reason is that this paper produces nearly nothing in dust. I find this is a lot nicer to work on, and secondly, less dust is less chance of smudging. And then my final reason, I think this paper needs no fixative to keep the pastel in place. I absolutely love this because whichever fixative you use, the colors on your piece will always turn out darker. I do have to mention that this is a very personal choice. You will have other artists who think that their piece needs fixative. But like I said, I don't think you need it, and for that I am in love with pastel mat. Now, what if you don't need a lot of layers? Then I believe pastel mat will still be a good choice for you. If you want to save on money, however, you could try another paper. I would suggest that you watch either my video on four different papers or the one about pastel mat in depth to get a better idea about your paper. Or you could always do a search on YouTube and see which other videos could help you out in your search for a good paper. Now, moving on to the second thing you'll need, and that is pastel itself. For starters, I think this will depend a lot on the type of art you would like to create. Are you going for a more expressive or abstract style, or a realistic style? Do you want to paint small or big pieces? These are all questions that are important to figure out what you should buy first. The first question you should answer is the one about size. How big do you want to draw? I would personally advise you to start with smaller pieces if this is your first try with pastel. For starters, your paper will be cheaper for a smaller piece, and you don't need a lot of pastel in comparison to a bigger piece. Secondly, which art style are you planning to pursue? Now I know this evolves as you go, but for your first few pieces, maintaining the same one will help you narrow your art supplies. So in a nutshell, I would advise the following. I would leave out the pastel sticks. I find these to be suited for sketching and hard lines only, and you can use pastel pencils instead. The pastel pencils, on the other hand, can be used for multiple purposes. I would also leave out the soft pastels to start with. The reason for this is pretty much only the price. I love these because of all the different colors, however, they cost quite a lot. They also aren't really suited for mixing colors, meaning you have to buy the colors you want and need. So for this reason, I think you are better off buying something else until you're sure that you love working in pastel. And then depending on your art style, I would either go for pan pastel or pastel pencils, or a combination of the two. If you want to make more of an expressive type of abstract art, or any art for that matter where you want your strokes to be bigger and bolder, I would suggest starting with pan pastel. With this, you won't be able to get in highly detailed strokes, but that isn't the purpose of your art anyway. Now, they are quite expensive to buy, but you only need to get the primary colors and a white and black. By using red, yellow, blue, You will be able to mix any color, and by adding white and black, you can play with the value and tone. This is one of the best features of Pan Pastel, by the way, the fact that you can mix any color you want. If, however, you want to make more detailed drawings, and this could be realism but this isn't even necessary, I would advise you to get the pastel pencils. This enables you to put down a lot of color as well as those detailed lines. It's for this reason I also advise you to start with small pieces, because getting in an underlayer for a large scale drawing with pastel pencils is neither time nor cost effective. So depending on the type of art you would like to create, I would either go with Pan Pastel or the pastel pencils. Another thing you could do, however, is combine the two. For example, say you want to create a few landscapes for your first pieces to test it out. You can get some greens and earthy tones in pastel pencils or any other color that suits your piece. I know this will limit what you can create, but the first time you buy pastels, it's all about testing if this is medium like to work in before going and break the bank. And with the combination of the 5 Pan pastels and the pencils you bought, you will be able to see whether or not you like working in pastel. When it comes to the brand of pencils you should buy, obviously this will depend a lot on your budget, but I strongly advise you the Carbotellos by Stabilo. These are quite affordable and they are extremely good for their price. They also fall in the middle when it comes to how hard or soft a pastel pencil can be. And for your first pencils, a more neutral brand is a great place to start. If you would like to learn more about these pencils, I've got a review about them teaching you everything you need to know about them. Now, once you've got your paper and your pastel, what's next? My advice would be to just experiment with them and have fun. Create whichever type of drawing that will make you happy. If you're someone who likes to have a little bit more guidance, make sure you look at some tutorials that you would like to follow and buy your pastels according to the tutorial you would like to follow along to. If you just like to play around, then you should just do that. Either way, if you've got the right kind of pastel and paper, you're already off to a great start. Happy creating, and hope to see you again next week. While all pastels. Oil pastel. For some reason, it's so difficult. Oil pastel. Make sure you do that right now. I've seen people. Absolutely. Why is that with me vandaag? I absolutely love it.
Is that van hier?
Pastel stick drop. See, they break, eh? Yeah.